lesson 6.2 is going to focus on properties of radicals. So I'm just going to go through a few examples and talk about the properties we'll be using in this lesson. So our first example has the square root of 75. So what we're going to do here is reduce the square root of 75. If you were to type it into your calculator, you would get 8 point something. It's somewhere between 8 and 9. And we're not going to use decimal values. We're going to reduce a radical. You can think of it like reducing a fraction. You want it in its lowest, simplest terms. So what we do is we take the square root of 75 and we're going to break it down into two numbers that multiply to 75. So you want to be very specific with the numbers that you choose. And if you remember from our last lesson, we made that list of all of our squared numbers. So we're going to go back to that list. 2 squared is 4, 3 squared is 9, 4 squared is 16, then we have 25, 36, 49, 64, 81. So I stopped at 81 because I'm trying to find which of these numbers fit into 75. 81 is too big, and I want to find the biggest one that fits in. So if you look through the list, you'll probably agree with me that 25 fits into 75. And how many times does it fit in? 3 times. So we break this down into the square root of 25 times the square root of 3, because 25 times 3 equals 75. So the reason why we wanted to pick that 25 is because we can take the square root of 25. The square root of 25 is 5. The square root of 3, none of these perfect square numbers fit into 3, so that stays as the square root of 3. And this is our reduced answer. It doesn't always look more reduced, but mathematically it is. So the square root of 75 and 5 times the square root of 3 have the exact same value. This is just in simplified form. All right, let's take a look at our second example. So here you can see that we are multiplying two square root numbers. So there's a property that tells us you can multiply them both underneath the same radical. And then you're looking at the square root of 108. Well, anytime that you guys get a square root answer, you're going to try to reduce it, like we did in the last example. You want to find the biggest number that fits into 108 from that list. That 4, 9, 16, 25, 36, and you just start dividing on your calculator till you find one that fits in. So 36 fits in 3 times, and then you want to make sure that this is the 36 is the biggest number that fits in. And if you're not sure if you picked the biggest one, you always look at the second number to help you out. Do any perfect squares fit into 3? And if none fit in, then that means that, yep, we picked the biggest number. So the square root of 36 is 6, and the square root of 3 just stays. So let me show you another way that you could do this problem. If you have the square root of 54 times the square root of 2, we could first reduce the square root of 54. If you look at all the perfect squares that fit into it, 4, 9, 16, 25, 9 fits in 6 times, and the square root of 9 is 3. So you have 3 times the square root of 6, and then I'm just going to bring down the square root of 2. Well, we can go ahead and multiply those two square roots together. It gives us 3 times the square root of 12. And now we always want to, anytime you get a square root, you want to see, can you reduce? Well, do any perfect squares fit into 12? You say, well, yeah, 4 fits in 3 times. And this 3 stays out front. Well, the square root of 4 is 2. Square root of 3 comes down. The 3 comes down, and we end up multiplying those together. And we end up with 6 times the square root of 3. And if you notice, we got the same answer that we had over there. So just another way to go about that. All right, you might have some examples where, you have a fraction within a square root. anytime you have this, I'm going to recommend that you try to see, can I reduce the fraction that's inside of the square root just to give yourself smaller numbers to work with? So 12 over 27, you can divide those both by 3. 12 divided by 3 is 4. 27 divided by 3 is 9. Now that we have the square root of a fraction, we actually saw this in our last lesson. You can break this apart, square root of 4 over the square root of 9, and that allows us to simplify. The square root of 4 we know is 2, the square root of 9 is 3. And we get 2/3. Alright, so this one is kind of opposite of what we just did. You can see we're dividing two square roots. So the property works both ways. We can go ahead and put these underneath the same radical with division, just like we did with multiplication. So what this allows us to do is go ahead and simplify the 192 divided by 3. And 192 divided by 3 is 64. And now can we reduce or take the square root of 64? And that equals 8. So we have simplified that down to an 8. All right, so this Name That Tune comes from the second concert that I saw in the 7th grade. This one I was very excited to go to over in Joe Louis Arena in Detroit. This was, at that time in my life, my favorite group to listen to. And as a matter of fact, I got to see them twice on a reunion tour within the last 5 or 6 years. So let me know if you recognize the group or the song.
Step by step, ooh baby, gonna get to you, girl.